Now, where's your wife?
Cameraman, this one man, I move the camera back to Hawaii. This one way, man.
No, no, no.
Why? This one man. This one man. I'm holding the camera for you.
Uncle wants you to hold it whilst you move this car here quickly.
Okay.
All right, so just listen.
Keep it steady.
When I look up, there must look up the sea.
Yeah. Ah. waiting to start with the procession from the residence to the church. So please stay tuned. Thank you.
No, 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 no. face. Yeah, but I just have to be closer to them so that when they're moving, you know.
Yeah, but this one.
That's fine, yeah, so I'll be here. Yeah, thank you.
It says, "Let him abide with me," on the page 18, 1-8.
Yeah.
That's our opening song for the service. Everything that we do and live as that service is about God. One thing as we gather in your spirit when within us. Here. every denomination or every organization has what we call articles of association of constitution. And when it comes to Christendom, there are different streams or denominations. There are the Catholic, there is the Presbyterian, there is the Methodist. We are also a different denomination. We are of glory, prophetic, apostolic organization. And we have our own constitution and articles. In other words, we have a way of doing things, our paradigm patterns. So I'm saying this to say that certain things may be a little bit different from maybe some of you are from Catholic or Methodist, but flow because every organization has its own constitution and the way they do things. So just flow with us today. And at the end of the day, may the Lamb, may the eternal Lamb of God, who was slain, receive his glory and the reward of his suffering today. In Jesus' name. Amen. Our Heavenly Father, we adore you. We thank you for this great God, for this Spirit to overcome. We ask that by your Spirit, everything will be done to your glory. Peace and traveling to me. When it's all said and said and done, we shall be careful to give you the praise and the glory. In Jesus' name. Amen. Alright, at this moment, we're going to enter into a short time of some praise and worship. Amen. Remember, as much as the occasion of pleasure, everything has to come to our Maker and our Creator. And interesting, at least all the family people I know, our social groups I don't know, all the ones I know are Christians. Some are preachers. Father is a pastor. Some of the sons is a pastor. So I believe they love to praise and worship God. So we are praying by amen. All right, so can we have them take us through some time of praise and worship? We can start with awesome God right now. And just flow some of the worship song question. You can see, feel free. You can see, you can start. Yes, I mean, flow.
Can we help you sound our feet?
Awesome God, as a man,
they call you God.
you are, but you're good time. You see me quite clearly. My soul will rise.
Assurance is on page 19 of our
humility. Just sit down, relax as you take. Yeah. Let's show.
Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in
Thank you, and God bless you. We continue by taking our ceremony continuously from Mami Sewa. Shall we welcome Mami Sewa?
Our second reading is from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 55 to 58. O death, where is your sting? O Hades, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain.
Amen, amen. Know that your labor is not in vain. Hallelujah. Now, our next hymn, how we are.
Prince
Bible reading from Brother Gilbert Andrew.
The third reading is from John chapter 11, verse 38 to 40. Then Jesus, again groaning in himself, came to the tomb. There was a cave, and a stone lay against it. Jesus said, "Take away the stone." Martha, the sister of him who was dead, said to him, "Lord, by this time there is a stench, for he has been dead 4 days." Jesus said, "And I will say to you that if you believe, you will see the glory."
Oh,
in communion with the Holy Spirit. And let's welcome the ministry of the senior minister of Brothers of Father and Ghost Ministry, Apostle Joe Martin.
Amen.
Amen. Today, as I shall not be brief, but there are two areas I want us to look at. Pastors, especially, at least pastors I know in Ghana, are accused of not appreciating critical thinking. So in most churches, especially in Ghana, politicians and unbelievers are telling the church what to do. Because they assume the church will not appreciate critical thinking. Today, I want to tell you two critical thinking, and I'm going to give you a reason why we should do. One, let me give you a footnote. I'm a student of philosophy or anatomic theology. I'm also a student of psychotherapy. I'm also a student of law. Hopefully, ending of the year, beginning of this, I'm going to do PhD in law. If somebody does philosophy, he appreciates critical thinking. If somebody does law, he appreciates evidence. If somebody does psychotherapy, he understands and emotions, all the cognitive and all,
he understands that.
Amen? Amen. I said this to say because of the things I want to analyze to you. Because that's in the house of mourning, we contemplate, we reflect, we think. And that's what we are going to do in a short time. I like doctors more than leading preachers. Doctors say, when you are sick, when you are poor, want to be happy, want to do our best. While preachers, when somebody is sick, but let them not heal, all they have are planning sooner. But doctors are saying, what can we do to save you? What can we do? That's what makes doctors more than leading preachers. How can I have good sermon? So how can I repent to nonsense? Now, my first argument, 2 points I want to make and I'll see them. The first thing is that Christians, if not all, almost all Christians, believe that at the rapture or parousia, the dead in Christ are righteous. Christians believe that. Christians also believe that at the judgment day, every human being shall be resurrected for judgment. Now, have we thought about the process or the procedure or the protocol of resurrection? Have we thought about it? Some Christians died 2,000 years ago. Some were burnt. People that were drawn to the sea, eating by fish. So they were drawn to the sea in North Africa, eating by fish. Some of the molecules or particles or atoms or protons have migrated to maybe Britain or America. So fish generally, they move, they migrate based on consensus. So when we talk about resurrection, think about it. Do you believe that God is going to bring particles of our bodies scattered all over the sea, all over the world, bring them together and resurrect it? 2,000 years ago, think about it. Do you believe this? You know, we like to share in the Christian world, but most of it, I will not believe what we say, and we talk about or read in the Bible, or the songs we sing. We don't believe it. If God can resurrect somebody, people were burnt into ashes at stake. If God can bring all those molecules, particles together, assemble them, and resurrect, can God, and yes, can God raise some of those dead for 1 year or 6 months? Critical thinking simply means evaluating and analyzing data or information. That's critical thinking. And critical thinking or argument, you have your point and you need reason or reasons. So number one, do we believe that in the rapture, when Jesus has read in the scripture, that death is Christ arises, do you believe it can happen? That people that were dead 2,000 years ago, the apostles, that God Almighty can bring them back to life. If you believe it, then first argument. Second argument, critical thinking. If that is it, we achieve that pastors don't accept. So everybody is telling us how we should run the church. Politicians in Ghana say, I've been down by people telling how the church should run. The second one, let's take a cost-benefit analysis data. In cost-benefit analysis data, we want to look at advantages and disadvantages when it comes to a situation or a data information. So let's look at advantage, disadvantage, weaknesses and strength, pros and the cons of a situation, of an argument. So let me ask a question. My second point, I'll be through very soon. Let's assume our dear sister Ellen resurrects, but he doesn't resurrect. We are talking about that. Let's talk about the advantages. Let's assume, because I have a problem with the apostles. They have been with Jesus. They went through apprenticeship. They went through mentoring. When Christ died, why couldn't one of them go to the Joseph of Arimathea and say, we saw who we were apprenticed in apprenticeship, in mentoring, and we saw our mentor, we saw how he raised Lazarus, we saw how he raised the son of the guy from me, we saw how he raised Jairus' daughter. We saw him. So let's give it a try. If you're an apprentice, you must practice it. Don't just not go to school just to follow their supervisors and that practice. Not only you have to be in the colleges, hospital colleges to practice. Why do they want to give them a try? Why didn't they? We saw the master doing it. And we are disciples, we are students. So let's talk about them. If the apostles have done that, let's assume they did it and they didn't, nothing happened. And whatever if they did it, let us somebody die and pray and the person is already. Do you know the advantages? The family will be happy. If everybody is not happy, then the children will be happy. The person who come back to life also will be happy. And then yes, some parents dying, I can understand. But personally, I don't understand somebody who's not even 50 years dying. I don't accept it. It is not God that killed them. But the thief came to steal, to kill, and to destroy. Less than 50 years. It is the devil. It is not God. So let's think about it. So somebody prayed and it didn't happen. If it happens, advantages are enormous. It's so plenty. Yes. But if it doesn't happen, listen to me. Only one thing can happen. And like me, I'm ready for that. It is the pastor who will be accused that he's proud. He's sure of. Look at what he did. So what? Personally, I have not any reputation of my own. Amen. I have no reputation of my life. Anything I have, anything is because of God. Nothing.
Amen.
In me, I tell people in this last day, nothing. I don't even have a car. The car I don't drive is my son's car. I use public transport. I don't care. Because my bag and my father was already rich. So I didn't do this job because of money. I responded with a mission.
Amen.
Matthew 10, 7 and 8 said, when you go preaching the gospel, heal the sick. Bless the leper, raise the dead. Yes. Within the same context.
Hey.
Why can I pray for the sick, but I cannot pray for the dead?
Hey.
Why can't we? And I'm saying that I have no reputation of my own. I'm not worried about what we, because, like us, I'm not ashamed of the gospel. And the gospel is inclusive.
Amen.
It's a three-dimensional gospel. It affects spiritual, physical, and emotional.
Mm-hmm.
What do you have got to lose? I would prefer to be called a fool for Jesus. Why? Because I acted upon the word of God.
Amen.
I would prefer to be called a fool for Jesus. After all, what do we have in this world?
Nothing.
Look at the end of everybody. Even the presidents, kings and princes. Look at their end. So we have no reputation of my own. I have no glory of my own. It is about Jesus. And as I know most of their family, and Sister Evelyn was so loving, loves God, very spiritual, praying for people. Praying for people. And I know if she was here, anybody in the situation should like to have seats.
Amen.
So these are the two words, the critical thoughts I want you to think about. Think about it, think about it. Critical thinking, it's better to go to the house of mourning, but there's reflection, there's contemplation, there's meditation. We think about our own lives, our destiny. What will I be? Am I children? We think, we reflect. Some of us, you have to go back to history. You lost a loved one. You begin to think. Some of you will be crying more today, not just because of holy head, but because of other people you lost and come to. But God has a bigger song. I want to praise God. As I said, short message, that these are what I'm doing with you. Can we just pick some song? I'm going to be praying for. As I call it, as you see on your program, as a ceremony, people have different ways of praying for their body. As I said, our donation is different. Hello? Every time, donation should throw in the incense, or perfume, or water, oil. That's what they have their own way of doing it. I'm also going to pray according to our denomination. Just think of all of it. Come back down here, let us pray. Yes, Baba, you must sing.
He paid the debt, he did not hope. I have no attempt, I could not pay.
Free
me,
Lord,
save
me.
Hallelujah.
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 Call me yours. Let's take it again.
When peace,
It was during the time in the UK, Evelyn worked in various community and hospital settings. She initially worked at Guy's and St. Thomas's Hospital for several years, where she excelled and became a mentor to junior colleagues. She transferred to the community nurse and worked for the Greenwich Community Nursing Team, where she again strived for excellence in the care of her patients, reaping success and successes. Her willingness to learn, the desire and determination to develop the skills required to provide the best level of care for her patients propelled her to become a nurse practitioner in 2018. With her empathic, compassionate, and her caring nature, as well as her effective teamwork skills and great sense of humor, Evelyn excelled in every department she worked in and became very liked by both patients and colleagues. With a good foundation she had had earlier in life through her upbringing by the UB family and the Nazi Jesus family, she even grew to become a stronger pillar in the family, serving the entire church, as Pastor Joe has already attested to, and the community as well. She enjoyed cooking and catering right from her teenage era in Lobito in Kumasi, where she grew until her last atom of strength and breath. As a result of this, her home was often a place of getting together with friends and family, especially Perpetua and all our friends. Her kitchen was never filled with food, not only to eat, but also for takeaway as well. Her availability to serve the church, as well as her contribution to helping the community, was immense and considerable, and we can't mention all. In 2003, Evelyn married her beloved Mr. Frank Kofi Sapon in Kent at the registry office of SIDCAP. They live in Bessonleaf, and their happy union has been blessed with Alicia and Kofi, who are aged 19 and 17 respectively, and they are here with us today. Evelyn ensured that she prioritized having her family, as well as excelling her career, to the delight and appreciation of the family. She was family oriented and yearning after family and friends. She was there for the family throughout all the challenges in her life, even on her dying bed. She was a strong pillar and did whatever she could to meet the welfare of the family, members of the family, and those who she loved. She became a role model. She changed my life, especially for the young women who have similar ambitions in attaining their career goals as well as meeting the needs of their families. Evelyn was ever humble. She was respectful and could hardly countenance arrogance. She always eschewed nonsense from all of us when we were growing. I lived with her all my entire life until she moved in 1997 to UK. She has been described by most to be a true woman of virtue and a great woman of substance who lived a life full of love and peace. She shared her God-given gift talent freely with many she encountered in life. Whatever Evelyn did, she carried it through with all her might and enthusiasm. Evelyn, losing you has created a great, huge void in the family. Words cannot describe the devastating sense of loss the family, the friends, and colleagues have felt ever since your unexpected passing away has caused us. We are mindful that everything you did here on earth was by the grace of God. You are a gift of God to us, and you will forever be a gift of God unto our lives and that of the world. Even though we love you, God loves you best and needed a super angel in you by his side. We are touched, we are consoled that you receive the word of God and the Holy Spirit as your guide before your maker called you.
Amen.
before your maker called you on the 28th of March 2022 as you slept peacefully at home with your loved ones by your side. They will cherish those moments for the rest of our living years. Farewell, Mama Evelyn. Thank you for coming. Thank you.
Continue clapping. God bless you, my brother. Work of blessed memory. Maya Angelou, captures it succinctly. She said, people will forget what you said. They will forget what you did. And they will never ever forget how you made them feel. Reflecting on that, and the enormous support and the compassion shown to the family since the 28th of March 2022, she could have waited any longer for me so we could have the last Easter egg. But I'm sure we will do that one day. When that family were together, and Mama said goodbye to those who were gathered close to her on the evening of that Mothering Sunday, there is no doubt in my brother's mind that that level of support must come from the way her dear IGB made all of us felt during the time we have known her in various capacities. And so he is humbled and continues to feel that way. I would like to encourage all of you to leave a sparkle wherever you go. That is his wish, and I hope you can make that happen for him. They go back a long way from growing up in the same vicinity in Kumasi, the garden city of Ghana. They were schoolmates in the primary school at Dwumfour International, the affluent suburb of Kumasi in Aswan. Attending separate boarding secondary schools outside Kumasi briefly separated them. Till as destiny will have it, their paths met again at the University of Ghana in Legon in 1995. The vivid collection of that faithful humid tropical evening, synonymous with Accra weather, my dear Adjumi came to Commonwealth Halls of Residence, Bandar City as they call it. With their friends, my brother's heart was raced. When he had set his eyes on her, his typical buoyant self disappeared on seeing her with an infectious smile. Initially, he was unsure how to broach the subject of a relationship and resorted to jokes and storytelling. Whenever she was around, hey, you know my brother, you know every 2 minutes to bring something out. Very nice about the smile. The interest grew when he realized she was a wonderful person. Together, we decided to build the future. We started dating, and the wonderful memories were the trips to Abu Saifa, the photograph meetings, the academic shows of the house, the Vandals Meet Food Fair. Life on university campus was the best because they were inseparable. That earned him the excellent Marco Home for his Christmas. And I assume you close your eyes, you find your life. Marco Home. University life breezed through in a flash, and the Jubilee returns to the United Kingdom to pursue a next career. My brother starts a banking career in Ghana. We later joined the Jubilee in the UK in 2002. From there, as we know, we got married to start to a family. The happy pairs with two wonderful children, Alicia and Goofy, bringing so much joy in the seal of life and what seems to be a perfect family life. The home was never dull, with one life and vibrancy throughout the years. The Jewish usual disciplinarian tendencies, scolding Coffee and not sparing the world, is something we will never forget to look after and heal. All these and despair with family vacations in Ghana, the United Nations, and Europe.
I know.
Which will always bring memories, memories you will hold dear onto and never forget. My Abner Jubi was a determined, committed, and ambitious woman who juggled family life with her career and kept her aspirations of continuous professional development. She was kind-hearted, touched many hearts, and left a sparkle in everything she made. Jimmy, Thank you for starting this journey with me. Thank you for making an impact in my life. Thank you for imparting such discipline to our children. And to me, you were my pillar, my confidant, the one who prefers another opinion, just so that we arrive at the solution. Without you, there would have been many wrong turns in my life, and none of our lovely children. For that, I say on behalf of Alicia and Kofi, and of course myself, we are grateful. We are grateful for sharing your life on earth with us. We are grateful that even though you're gone, your spirit will still be with us. Your friendship, your encouragement, believe in me, the faithfulness, the love, and respect will forever stay in me. You have been a wonderful wife to me, and a great mother to our kids, and will be dearly missed. Fare thee well, my darling Richard. Sleep well, darling. To you, my man. When I'm if I will see you, that's right, man. If I will see you at home, it's to see you, be sure. And then I'm here, don't tell me, he knew. You don't die, won't you, my father, yeah? The total of sin and myself. But if you can't, the cold may kill you. I pledge you with the year. Come back, the year. And Tina Mija will bring, and the big tradition. Yes.
And you tell me that it's gonna heal the time. three words I pointed at the field was the soul daunting experience. How incredible I have learned to trust and run in the hands of America. No more weeping, no more pain. Mom, we fought a hard battle, a battle that was painful and emotional. I will never forget how wonderful you were, a caring mother and a teacher. You can never stand in front of any time you felt. But all the money and pain you feel past, I won't be able to explain. But because she loved us and cared so much about education, she was still paying. He invested so much in your children, and I promise you, we'll make you proud. We hope you have a wonderful day. Your story touched us. Your testimony changed lives. It pushed me to draw closer to God. Times when I thought we need to pray early in the morning and I complained that you're making too much noise. And you say the time you used to complain, you could have prayed with me. Even when I felt like all was not well, you told me that he's never give up on God. Whilst you were enduring through your pain, you were still praying and believing. Saturday evening, she'll show me what she wanted to wear to church and ask for my approval, but never actually took it because she didn't care about my pain and feelings either. When it came to fast food, forget about McDonald's, KFC, and Tasty House. When we came there, it was yam and spinach on me and coffee. But what puts me at ease is that I know that heaven has named a beautiful angel. As long as I live, I will never forget you, and your legacy will reign. You have touched so many people with your selfless, kind, caring, and loving heart. Thank you for the very last Mother's Sunday spent with you. The day before you passed on, when you called us your children, including Kofi, KB, Asantua, Renata, and myself, and the Madeiras, to come and have service with you, as if you knew your last breath was a few hours away. That beautiful day will mark good memories as the years go on. Your endless love for your children will never be forgotten. You look after everyone as your namesake, Mama Evelyn. For sure, you are a mother to us all. The song I sang to you that day was "He is able," and the words are very clear. God will do just what he says he will do. He's going to fulfill every promise to you, including concerning your children. God is able to do just what he said. He's gonna fulfill every promise to you. Don't give up on God, 'cause he won't give up on you. He's able.
Oh,
quiet this world broke my heart to you. I wish you could have said it. I wish you could have said it long days ago, but I know that I don't need you. I think about it all the time, long days and since ago. And how lucky I was to have a brilliant mother like you. You weren't just a mother, but you were also a dear friend to me. Sometimes you had our arguments, but you were always there out of love. You are a generous, kind, and caring woman. You love to serve others. You taught me how to love, to be patient, and to be kind. And for that, I will be forever grateful. It will be impossible to say all the favorite memories I have of you, because there are too many. I pray God keeps you by our side and takes you to meet again.
Amen.
We will forever be a part of you. I know you're praying for us every day, just as you can do with us. This isn't a goodbye, but it's to see you soon. Because I know you're with me every step of the way, and in every moment of my life. I know you are looking up for me. I love you so much, man. See you well and enjoy the rest.
Until we meet again, sleep on, my dear sister.
Rest well, my best friend.
Thank you, Sister Betty. Thank you. You have done what good friends do. God bless you. God bless you. We now move to Adage by Sister Sudan. Shall we welcome Sister Sudan on stage?
Mommy is through. before. Nenso eya shenti. Osa kan professor ese. Look back and find a friend. I don't understand it. But I will go she had in dream one. Now we will talk to me say. And yes, I have a father before. Then so, ya da kuta wono e ya, mi niya akriye. Yee! Akuna se, pepe wono, neni ye ajiye. Neni ajiye. Na pepe wono ni kutu na ye mwati, tawa ye ti akumachi shwe ni asana misiye. Ya di mi tira posane ni so anope. Ya di akumachi shwe ni na ye jay meno. Mi drufi fi no uji akumano. Apana misiye se ki. When you go to a new market or say, some catch them over a body, a sinza, and you tell a coffee, or you take a little bit of a day, and you say, I want you on your own, and you see, or the four shabby. Coffee to one, Alicia, oh, I mean, crap, or the brown, and then say, when you want to finish it here, nurse so, or the other I'm all better, and you see, shedding. Yeah, it's all about telling me and better to you. And I'm afraid, it's all good to see why I'm only ever telling me. Bamu, who cried here, who be back into me, and then a plan, the catch was a G, the refit G. Jimmy, I'm a good. Yeah, no. Not even that I'm not a one for you. We can't say Papa said to any two copy. Now you can say, ah, I tell you to be traveling in the sun, they won't be any little copy. I'm not saying you what? Ah, you're soon. I just see what Jack told me what happened. Did you want to see me? Yes. And I said, ah, I'm not happy.
And also the peace of God and the grace of God upon everyone. Thank you.
Gentlemen, please come forward now. Thank you.
I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do that.
Hello. I am out. Major,
Ladies and gentlemen, yeah, we're trying to get to the heads and follow them so that we can give you the whole procession. But in case the live streaming fails or stops, please go to Dwumfour TV2 to continue. Dwumfour TV2, that's what's showing on there. If you go to Dwumfour TV2 and keep checking, you know, if we've started again, then, you know, can continue that with us. So stay tuned. Thank you.